And what is going on, guys? My name is Vekman, and we are back with a brand new reaction. We're checking out something new, something very new, actually just came out a couple hours ago. We got Dark Times, the sixth studio album from Vince Staples. Now, I honestly don't have that big of a history with Vince Staples' music. He's kind of like Freddie Gibbs or any of the other artists that I've kind of been recently checking out on here, where I've heard some of his songs, and I really, really, really enjoy some of his songs. But I just haven't ever really decided to dive into his shit. I mean, the dude's just funny as fuck, honestly. I love him more as a comedian, honestly. His shit that he did, the Vince Staples Show, fucking hilarious. I believe he did the Cave with Kenny Beats, another fucking just hilarious video on YouTube. I highly suggest that you go check that out if you haven't seen it. But yeah, like, I know of his personality, but I don't really know so much of the music. I know a lot of his more bigger, like mainstream shit, like North, obviously. There's a couple other ones, but like I'm a very extremely surface level Vince Staples fan. And I figured we should just say fuck it, why not? This is a new album, brand new album. And we might as well jump into it. I did hear quite a bit of Ramona Park, or what was it? Ramona Park Broke My Heart. I did hear quite a bit of that album. I never listened to it though in full, and I did thoroughly enjoy that, or at least what I did hear of it. So I am quite excited to hear what he has to bring on this record. The title interests me, as well as the track list. I mean, there's no listed features on here, so I don't know if this has any features on it or anything along those lines. More than likely not, is just gonna be my assumption. But I was originally gonna react to Shame on the Devil, but every time that I would try to record, my computer would just fucking bug out and destroy itself. But it seems everything's working now, so we're locking in. We're gonna tap in right now. We got Dark Times by Vince Staples. Let's go. Track one, Close Your Eyes and Swing, and it's only 30 seconds long, so I'm gonna let it play into track two, which is Black&Blue. But damn, I do kinda wanna close my eyes to this shit. That beat knocks. This shit's been playing for 3 seconds. Hold on. This is not what I was expecting off rip, dude. I love this fucking song. It's only been a minute, we're not even halfway through, and I love how he's starting this shit. That is amazing. Oh my god. To the heavens above, is it a match for dust? Tupac and them go, when them see hustling them go. Swivey and Draco, Richie's and Slimfo. I spend a lot of my time missing our kinfolk. Put them inside of a rhyme, hoping they live on. Money, I'm getting it. Heaven, I'm living it. My mind's kind of blown, bro. Like, again, I'm not like a super like hardcore Vince Staples fan. I don't know much of this dude's discography. I don't know if that's the energy that he typically brings, but what I do know is that I've heard a lot that Vince Staples is an amazing artist. And from the bits that I have heard, he has a very versatile style. He brings something new to the table with almost every record. And if this is the energy that we're on for this album, I'm locked in. That was beautiful. Fucking beautiful. The beat felt so open. The drums were amazing. The beat felt open. I love the little background, almost choir. I don't know if that was like a sample or not on the hook. And then that drop into it was perfect. fucking perfect. That song is insane. I'm bumping that shit on repeat. God fucking hell yeah, dude. That's awesome. Going into track number three, we got Government Cheese.
I promise it's no love lost, but that head fake a house in the slums cost. If I gave it my all, probably fall short. Tryna charge to the game, it's a blood sport. Another day closer to my demise, keep that gang.
My God, bro. He's fucking spitting. Hold on, pull that back. Pull that back.
Grace, bro. Just another day closer to my demise, keep that gang.
I didn't pull back enough, but the whole... If I prayed, I think I'd have more to say. This is another day closer to my demise. Like, God, I keep stuttering because I don't know like what to say. I'm so happy that this is the sound. Like, I love this type of sound, and there are so few people who really can tap into it in a good way. I'd say the majority of them, the only other one that really can come to mind is like Mac Miller. There's a couple of others that I'm thinking of, but I cannot get their names for the life of me right now. But like this kind of sound of slowed down, laid back vocal, but with hard punchy ass beats is amazing. And when you execute it well, it is so fucking beautiful for the listener. This is already an example of that. It could change throughout the album. It could totally change. But these, like, the first, like, two or three songs are already setting a tone that I love.
Around is the ones that stay down. Let us see their face smell. Let us see their heads heal high. Yeah. Everybody gotta die. Only question is the hell they're in the sky. Yeah. Don't forget to smile. Forget to smile on the way down. Not now, then when, not this.
Some Mac DeMarco sounding shit.
Don't forget to smile. Boss, heard his name is God. Just pick up when I call. Right now it's free of charge. And don't forget to smile. Don't forget to smile on the fucking way you down. Not now, then when, not this thing now.
I'm not getting over the how hard it is to leave him hanging when you're the money tree. That's tough. That's tough.
Don't forget to smile. Don't forget to smile, don't you?
Oh man. Yeah, another example. Just like I was talking about with Black&Blue. Fucking beautiful. The vocals are they're not quiet. They're relaxed. They're relaxed like he's comfortably talking in a room by himself where he doesn't feel like unnerved to say anything around anybody, and it sounds so fucking good. The telling of the conversation with his buddy who's locked up, talking about having everybody kind of look up to you, or you're kind of the sole guy that they're kind of chasing after, then how it feels to leave him hanging when you're the money tree. That's tough. That's tough as fuck. That's That's dirty. Going into track number four, we got Children's Song. Oh. Okay. Oh.
Rising fire to the pen from my Aphex twin in the street light. I ain't really trying to scrape that rent. Niggas be light. Hey, bro, remember back when? Let it go low. I way too risk to be your friend. I way too lit.
He flexing. Granted, he deserves that shit. Nah, Vince Staples has worked his ass off in his career, dude. I like, again, I've been such a bystander on all this shit. But dude has put out quality work after quality work from what I hear. And I mean, he's still going today, and I don't feel like there was ever a point in his career where, for how much buzz I heard about him from people whose opinions I very much trust, with how many people talk so good about his music, I don't feel like he's ever gotten the credibility that he probably deserves. And after listening to this shit, just this portion of the album, I feel like They're probably right. He probably does deserve a lot more recognition, but like, holy shit, man. They let you damn me. Niggas can't damn. Run around South Pasadena on a 10 speed. And I still got blitz. And I still get tricky. It is what it is. Don't play with my crib and go play with your kids, bitch. Don't play with my crib and go play with your kids, bitch. Not what the devil intended. It's money outside, go and get it. Make a ticket. Up all night with the smokers and crickets. I've been broke on my life, had to flip it. All these grown niggas living off women.
Man, they doing what?
That ain't no real shit. Don't play with my crib and go play with your kids, bitch. Oh, I don't. I'm gonna run that back. I'm gonna run that back. That definitely has a transition. That was, I think, the shortest one so far. Very concise, but still great. Love that fucking song, and I love the hook on it too. Don't play with my crib and go play with your kids, bitch. Real shit. Why the fuck? Why? Like, why even? You got bigger issues in your life, bro. Go. All right. I'm gonna run it back though, but we're going into track number 5. Shame on the devil. I'm pulling up to transition. Here we go. Oh. Dude, the drums are... Oh, my God. I love them.
I long for loving and affection. These hoes ain't what I need. I need direction. Don't leave me, please. Swear I learned my lesson.
I'm on the devil, I'm touched by an angel alone. Made me special, so special. I pray for days like this.
Oh, I love that singing.
Mission complete, out of the mud. Label the leader, they following good. Light on my feet, floating above. I don't be creeping and keeping in touch. I know some hoes that'll pull up to give me some pussy before they come give me a hug. Shit is disgusting.
Made me special, made me special.
Yeah, this is getting attitude like songs too. It's slow. It's such a fucking vibe. Another amazing track. Definitely a different vibe from everything else so far, but that slowdown is beautiful. Amazing. The vocal, the harmonizing kind of section on the hook sounds amazing. The beat the entire time sounds open, like it's just being drowned in like an empty fucking cave. And the drums are banging too. I loved his fucking vocals on that as well. They still had that laid back tone, but there was definitely some points where I felt like his flow was picking up. But like, just beautiful, beautiful track from top to bottom. Going into track number 6, for the sake of not embarrassing myself, I'm not even going to try to pronounce that, but we're going into track number 6. Let's go.
That's how I be happy. This for all my niggas trapping out of bands. My ladies on stage, ass clapping. Transaction, cause your mama need a mansion. Make the city proud. Put it on for them crackers, come and tear it down. What are you about? In the ghetto,
I'm a Martian. Hold on, nah. He was spitting there in that intro. He said, label telling me to bring the streets back. The fans saying that they want that 2015 Vince back. Talking about, what did he say? Was it Big Fish Theory? I think so. Yeah, man, fucking, oh my God. He said everything after Big Fish Week. I mean, from what I've heard from Vince, that is not at all fucking true, bro. Like, again, I will say up front, I have not heard Big Fish Theory. I know this album is highly looked up to. I have not heard it, so I can't speak to it. But what I can say is that I ain't heard it, and I know that people look up to it. But I mean, shit, I may have to go check out what people consider peak Vince Staples. Honestly, again, like, this album so far is pretty fucking amazing. I don't see how it could get much better than this, honestly.
In the dirtiest apartment, stay shy. I've ever been the hardest, big time. I can
tricks by your treats, no love. I'ma sleep with my weapon, Porsche 911. I don't need your flowers, I'm living. First time I seen $1 million, I'm squinting. Broke me a pack to help me hustle, submission. Came a long way from the project buildings. That's where granny went when she left Louisiana, trying to dodge Jim Crow. But you can't escape the master stained glass windows. Got my vision from the past, I'm probably finna go to hell. But it don't matter, seen heaven on earth. I could've been up on the shirt. If I ain't get my shit together, go to work. I've been hitting the lick since flip verse first. Riding with the stick like witchcraft. Finding beauty in the darkness like Rembrandt. Everybody gang, gang, gang till it get bad. Do you hear me? The ghetto was a mismatch.
Yeah, huh? Why, yeah.
The fuck? It's a wild switch up on the end. Okay. Hell yeah. Again, not gonna try to pronounce the name of the track because I cannot pronounce that and I'm just gonna embarrass myself trying, but love the fucking flow of it. Also like the message inside of the lyrics, in the beginning part, just talking about like just pressure on himself. Talking about, you know, the label trying to give me advice saying that they want me to bring the streets back, fans saying they want that 2015 Vince back. Again, referring to obviously you got people pulling you in two different directions. And then in the second half, again, just talking about, I think, his own, like, personal struggle, just with everything else going on in his life, what he expected out of everything and what it's become. But, I mean, again, shit, another banging fucking song. And I like the outro there, too. The hook went repeated itself a couple of times, but I like that little switch up there, that just a wild clash into like, way more turned up, happy-sounding shit, right back into that more kind of spacey, almost gray-sounding sounding beat, basically. But yeah, another fucking amazing song. Going into track number 7, we got Liars, which looks like it may just be a little, like, short skit type of thing. It's only 57 seconds long, so I'm gonna let that play into track 8, Justin.
If I love you, I can't lie to you.
Of course you can lie to me, and you will. If you love me and you're going off with Maddie someplace, you're lying to me. Because what the hell do I care about the truth? I care if you're there. Let Billie Holiday say, hush now, don't explain. Very minimal. And I'm saying, you know, fake it with me.
This pretty woman in the summer from Qatar. Late night at Jelena, she was eating at the bar. Said she was the teacher, 7 months left on the visa. But she used to be a singer, she was meant to be a star. Ask me how I feel about the music I done dropped. Can barely hear the ambulances over helicopter. She invited.
I apologize if I'm being really quiet. At least through this track, I'm trying to, like, I'm listening to what this motherfucker's saying. He's telling a story right now.
Hear the ambulances over helicopter. She invited me up for a drink. I don't indulge, but the moments with her made me feel so. What's the rush? Started talking about the future and the ever present past. Aqua silences and laughs got me feeling like we on the path to something. Right before this woman stole my heart, I see a shadow by the door and hear a knock. Eyes bloodshot like she has seen a ghost or something. I don't know what's what. Reach in my pocket, get the clutch, and she like, hold up, I'm coming. If it get tricky, then I'm busting. She said, baby, meet my little cousin Justin. Damn.
Ah.
Nice to meet you.
Women lie a lot. Put that on the dead. On me. Women lie a lot.
It's funny because, like, he's spitting real shit. He said women lie a lot, put that on the dead homies. Yeah. Yes.
Women lie a lot.
Yeah, man. Fucking fantastic storytelling on that song. Like super vivid picture painted in my mind. Like, it's not even one where it's like he's just dropping like breadcrumbs for you to like kind of pick up. He is really painting it in the fucking verse. And that switch up there, it, obviously, the plot twist to it, and it coming right after a little sample about being a liar in a relationship. But yeah, man, like, oh, just fucking, oh, man, just absolutely fucking a beautiful song. Amazing track. Love the beat. Again, love Vince's performance on it. Amazing. Going into track number 9, we got Radio.
Radio. miss the radio. Big boy in the morning, zoned in, waiting for my favorite show. Riding with my pops in the front seat, pull up to the block, hit the real G. Back when niggas had the rhythm and blues. I turned up my hustle, I turned up my section, I turned up my bitch. I turned up my savage.
I like those scratches.
I turned down the street and I made me a hit. Just like you. Worst. Wasn't really trying to hear her till she kicked me to the curb. Now was Smokey Robinson, and after that I played Roberta Flack. Had a James and Amy waiting for the day she take me back. Michael and his brothers made me wonder about who loving you. Brandy understand me, broken hearted sitting in my room. I got a lot on my chest. Can you play my request?
Oh.
I turned up my hustle, I turned up my section, I turned up my bench. I turned up my savage, I turned down the street and I made me a hit.
Again, he's painting a super fucking vivid picture.
Just like me.
Yeah, another fucking beautiful song. It feels like radio's being used as a metaphor for something, and I feel like I'm missing it, but like I'm picking up on it at the same time. But like, just turning to something to help you, you know, relieve your stress as a whole. But like at the same time, he kind of talks about like the sentimental value of it. But then in the second verse, like laying out just like a shitty day, and he's like, "I got a lot on my chest. Can you please play my request?" That's fire, so fucking fire. I love that fucking song, dude. And again, it's another one, the slower toned beats, and him just kind of chill rapping on it, and it fucking sounds beautiful. Sounds fucking amazing. Going into track number 10, we got Nothing Matters.
Band plays on like it's supposed to follow suit, because it ain't nothing new. Beneath the solar systems of oppression got me a loop. The web controller's puppet master got me shining his shoes. Collecting quarters, didn't know I was about that life till his was over. You worry about the wrong things, wrong things. Nothing really matters at all. Nothing really matters. Nothing really matters at all.
I love the very simple drums.
But baby, everybody love me, I'm a joint. Tall tales, I know all too well. Cause every moment that we share felt like a Polaroid. Sometimes you gotta shake it up to see what's really there.
Oh my god. Sometimes I feel like every moment that we share is like a Polaroid. You gotta shake it up to see what's really there. Bro. That's an IG caption. The fuck?
Is it in the air? Why would you tell me that you love me when you don't? No time for arguing, I'm hanging up the phone. You made a promise, said you never do me wrong. Guess that doesn't matter. Nothing really matters.
We're arguing, I'm hanging up the phone.
Who is this?
You made a promise, said you'll never do me wrong. Guess that doesn't matter. Really matters at all.
Who the fuck is that? Again, slowed down. But I mean, it's becoming very, very clear. This album feels like Vince reflecting on a lot. And I don't know, Dark Times obviously being, you know, a dark time, but it feels like him really reflecting on a lot of shit in his life. But like, man, it's just fucking beautiful. Like, there's no other way around it. Like, it really is. And you know, it's even more sad, because if this was written during a dark time in his life, then it's like, a lot of times artists put out their best work when they're going through the most pain, I feel like. But like at the same time, it's a win-lose situation. This has nothing to do with that song, but like just as a whole, you always hear people say that like, oh, like this artist's best, you know, album came out when they were, you know, or like around like this time, and then you look at that time and then like their life was like just in the gutter. So, like, anytime, like, really good music comes out, there's always a small concern, at least for me, that I'm like, are they okay, though? Because, like, man, some of these people, like, they do a really good job of hiding it, but some others, like, man, they are just really fucked up whenever they're trying to make some good music. But, yeah, no, man, another fucking beautiful track. Going into track number 11, we got Little Homies. Mm.
Chase checks, little homie, cause the money bring the power and respect, little homie. Get some dollars to your mama and invest, little homie. Do you, don't worry about the rest, little homie. Just be blessed, little homie. You don't gotta crash out for the set pressure. You feel me? Life hard, but I go harder. Life hard, but I go harder.
Life hard, but I go harder. That's real. That's real. That is a mentality that a lot of more fucking people, I feel like, should have. Like, obviously, it could just be a lyric, but, like, if he, like, really does feel that way, I feel like a lot more people need that kind of fucking mentality, bro.
Hard, but I go harder. Streets cold, but the road's harder. Concrete, where the road blossom. Life hard, but I go harder. Mm. Hey, don't crash out. Last time niggas tried me, it was R.I.P.s, it was airbrush T's, it was glass sitting on concrete. Love the meat side streets, running with fly meets for they book, cuz let pack free. For the F's turned ICG. I was basically trying to make plays, cuz a broke ass nigga don't eat.
If he's bitch, what kind of nigga saying money don't make you rich?
Cuz he was bugging, blow the budget, baby, cut me a check. They argue when I buy my net worth over the net. They quantifying everything I ever did for the set. When every nigga living for it, still living in debt. It's so ironic, so iconically platonic, but sex is what she wanted. Sorry, I can't move my 2 o'clock. Bad decisions over women, everybody won. Left with nothing but a broken heart. You feel it?
Life hard, but I go hard. Life hard, but I go hard.
Show me where the makes those clouds. Just don't look down. Please don't look down.
Man. That song is just inspirational as shit. I mean, honestly. Yeah, man. I feel like the message behind that song is just keep pushing. Keep doing your shit. Even, like, that end part, like, wraps it all up 100%. Things are getting better. Keep your head up. Like, abso-fucking-lutely. That is just full-on inspiration. To, like from, like, top to bottom. Going into track number 12, we got Free Man. If this is a diabolical sample flip, I'm gonna be fucking. Hit me with it. I can feel something cooking up right now. Let him cook. One, two, three.
Nowadays, 100 can't even get in my glance. Ain't even setting up no meat until they meet the demands. An undisclosed amount from Netflix invested. I turned a set into a movie set for all of the kids to see who you can be if you believe you bigger than this. Don't be no crab in the bucket, be a crip at the wrist. Them crackers see me in the suite and try to call up the pigs, but we know they don't fly. The top flow way too high, feel like the time flew by. Been 10 plus years, lost love, lost peers. Shed blood, shed tears. Cheers, grab a glass, I never find an equal mind. I settle for the fattest ass. I'm trying to make a way, and all she says, babe, you make me live. Only heaven knows whichever way I blow in the breeze. I'll be a fool to think it's left up to me, but I appreciate the love, loved one. Still young and trying to figure out the ins and outs of where we from. Heal the blocks that we spun, the concrete crack. Heavy stepping, niggas won't get back. Right?
Another fucking one. And again, the message behind that one, like the past couple of songs just feel inspiring. I don't know why. I mean, obviously, I feel like it's got to do with the messaging in it. But like that one, it just radiates like this. I am setting myself up to be free. I am free. Like, he doesn't rely on anybody at this fucking point. And he's not like hoping that somebody can hand him like another check. Like, he is free. And I think he said turn the set into a movie set to let these kids see something about, you know, their full potential. Just another fucking beautiful fucking song again. And I'm kind of sad because we're moving into the last track on this album. Track number 13, Why Won't the Sun Come Out? Let's go. Crazy. It's easier for a girl to come over and give you pussy than it is for a girl to come over and give you a hug. Damn. That's deep. That is deep. Holy shit. Alright, we're closing it out with the ambient sound like it didn't. And that was Dark Times by Vince Staples. What do I think of that album? I am shocked. Very happily. That was an amazing fucking album. I'm kind of pissed. I'm kind of pissed because I had caught wind of the single coming out earlier this week. And I was like, cool, I want to check that out. And then obviously, again, had the issues with recording, so I was like, whatever, I won't even listen to it, I'll just wait for the album to come out. But I'm pissed, but I'm happy, because I wish that I had heard Shame on the Devil, like, a couple of days ago. I would have probably had that shit streamed, like, 100 times by now. But, on the plus side, I got to hear it for the first time with the context of the actual album itself, which, I mean, that transition into it was fucking amazing. So, I mean, everything on here from top to bottom, honestly, was amazing. There was a lot of use of sound samples from people just, like, talking, conversations, shit like that. And I think if it's overdone, it can get overbearing. But it felt like they all had a good place. Like, there was a reason for it all on this record. Every beat felt great. Whoever executive produced this album, fucking shout out to you. Because you killed this shit. Whoever produced these fucking tracks. If it's Vince himself, God fucking bless. If it's whoever it is, they deserve a goddamn... Fucking, you're amazing. Alright, I hope you have the greatest rest of this fucking year. Beautiful production. Vince Staples killed his part on everything. The vocals were perfect. I think his energy level perfectly matched the aesthetic of every single beat and the tone of every single beat. The lyrical content was there when it really needed to shine through, and it fucking did. And, I mean, just across the whole board, it feels like there's a lot of versatile stuff here showing Vince's just... I guess creativity as an artist, and also his just ability as an artist, to create these different sounding tracks that all come together perfectly. But I mean, at the end of the day, this was a fucking amazing album. I'm so happy that I checked this shit out. Again, beautiful, beautiful record. Shout out to Vince Staples. This was an amazing record. And from what I know, I think this was also his last album on Def Jam. So, congrats, you're out of your record deal. but, yeah, man. Hell yeah. I thoroughly did enjoy that album. A lot of bangers. I need to go back and listen to that. And it's not a super long LP either. So, like, it's definitely one that you can just kind of throw on top to bottom and enjoy multiple times, which I absolutely love from albums. But, yeah, man. Again, let me know what you guys think of the album down below in the comments. If you guys did enjoy the video, be sure to hit that like button. Also, be sure to hit that subscribe button. We got this, who just came out. I'm going to be listening to this. There's a couple of other singles, and I think maybe an album that I want to check out and probably upload this upcoming weekend or week. And then we got Eminem coming up next weekend with something. I don't know if it's a single, or I don't know if it's the death of Slim Shady. All I know is I'm here for it. All I know is we're going to be here. We're going to be reacting to it. I'm ready for that shit. Got a lot of stuff still coming up. Summertime is in full fucking effect. I mean, everything's just coming out right now. So Absolutely. We got Bangers for Days coming out. We got great music. We got mid music, but mostly, honestly, great music, which that's a win for the listener. So, absolutely. Again, I appreciate you guys so much. Thank you guys for stopping by and watching. And yeah, it's been Vecman. Peace out.